We started the jam in like 1972. We started off just playing pubs. It was just fun days, you know, all fooling about drunk in the back of a van and all that stuff, and just good fun.
Yeah, carefree. Yeah. It's Absolute Radio. It's Danielle Perry and Paul Weller doing Through the Decades. And now we sidestep into the 70s. And of course, in 76, the jams. I mean, this was when you were, you know, the decade where it did start for you. So when you think back to the 70s as a moment, a decade, what do you remember from that?
Well, the good bits were was the music. And I liked T-Rex and Bowie, Slade. But then I also liked a lot of soul music and a lot of reggae music I heard in the early 70s. I also remember the three-day weeks and the blackouts and all that stuff, you know. And England was in kind of really in decline financially, economically in decline, you know. There's a lot of music that was around in the mid-70s. It was a lot of sort of stadium rock and American, generic American rock, and I didn't really relate to any of that stuff, you know. So this was kind of all leading up to punk happening, really.
And then sort of early days of jam for 1976 as well. I mean, do you remember some of those early shows? Any memories you could share with us on that?
Yeah, well, I mean, me and my mate Steve Brooks, I met at school, and we started the jam in like 1972 when we were both like, I don't know, 14 or whatever we were. We started off just playing pubs and workmen's clubs and social clubs. And then we got a drummer and then we got a bass player, and so it went. And so we played pretty much every weekend, you know, and we'd play a Friday, Saturday, sometimes a Sunday night. That was our schooling, I suppose, you know what I mean? That was our kind of, us learning our trade as such, you know, playing to lots of disinterested punters in these places. But it was all good groundwork, you know, and it served me well in later years as well.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. It's like training the boards, isn't it? If the amp goes or your pedal board or something, then it...
So I had a good sort of 5 or 6 years of that.
Yeah,
and I'm glad I did. You know,
you got a smile on your face when you think back to that. When
it was just fun, you know.
Yeah,
it was just fun days. You know, all fooling about drunk in the back of a van and all that stuff, and just good fun.
Yeah,
carefree.
Yeah. Did you ever do a residency anywhere?
We did a residency for 2 years in a little nightclub called Michael's in Woking.
Right.
We played every Friday night for 2 years.
God.
And
it's a lot.
And we used to cart our stuff up and down these steep stairs, two flights of stairs. And it was just that was an experience anyway.
Yeah, yeah. I'd like residencies to return. I think they're quite a nice idea for bands and venues.
Yeah, it's a shame there was way more venues back at that time. It was probably before they brought in the whole music license thing, you know.
Mm.
So you could sort of literally turn up at a pub and ask the landlord, say, can we play here? And, you know, often they'd let you do it.
Yeah.
But it's a shame, you know, because you could, in London especially, you could go and see a different band every night of the week, you know.
Mm.
There were so many pubs holding live music, and it'd be nice to see that coming back a bit, really.
Yeah,
I don't know if it ever will do, but...